Mr. Marachek, you sneaky bastard. Not to worry, I can speed up this little family reunion.
What have you done with Rebecca?
She's right here. Yeah.
Where?
Rebecca!
You took away my life's work, Mr. Marachek. Now let me return the favor.
Oh my god.
Cage 7 open.
Enjoy the show. I'm off to deal with Judas.
Cage 7 open? Becca plays in the room, clearly unaware of how close you are. The plastic sheeting below you is spattered with vile fluids. IV tubing. These transparent tubes are used to pump liquids directly into the body. You pump liquids into my body as well? A surgical observation room would provide an excellent view of any procedures being performed below. Door. I guess I can't get in that door. Did he take my inventory? He did. Not surprising. Well, at least my PDT is here. Have I read this? A data imprint of John Marachek is running through this PDT and its innocuous circuits. Recycling drain. An organic soup is congealed around the edge of the recycling drain. Gas pipes. Filled with the hiss of gas and bubbling of liquids, the pipes penetrate like thick tree roots into the computer systems below. Computer racks. The large metal doors are locked into place. Wooden writing desk. The familiar smell of wood polish creeps through the air from the wooden writing desk. Leather chair. Stressed and cracked leather shows the age of Dr. Malin's chair. Second level. Oh, this says the same thing as this door. So we need to get through this door somehow. We also need to save her. I don't know if that's possible. I can take my PDT. DNA scanner. Sits idle awaiting genetic material for processing. No. Oh, I can't get back over here? I'm obviously just supposed to head to this and then something's gonna happen. She's probably gonna be killed, which is why I've been putting this off. Just in case there's some kind of quick puzzle that I might fail. Oh god.
Rebecca, no! Rebecca! Run! Kill me! Take me! Rebecca! Rebecca, no! Rebecca! No! Kill me! Take me! Rebecca! 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 Rebecca!
Wouldn't have a happy ending.
Oh.
the hell is singing? Is that recorded from my wife before she died? Singing to her? Oh, can't hurt now. Bloodstained glass. Oh, just three more hits and I would have got through. This once comforting toy's fur tufts are now stained with fresh blood. The pink bedspread is spattered with blood. So where'd the creature go?
John? I understand you're emotional.
Oh god, are you kidding me?
Still get Ellen. You can save her.
Well, she's upstairs, though. She's on the bed, wasn't she? Wasn't she one of the ones being operated on? Well, they didn't indicate she was dead, right? I kind of thought she was.
Daughter's DNA into the scanner.
I'm living in a nightmare. I can't do this. I just can't do this.
You don't have a choice. Lan is a monster. We need to find Ellen. You need to put Rebecca's blood into the scanner. Now!
Well, who is this lady, and what role does she play in all of this? I don't think she's just in it to help Marichak. I think she has her own goals. Maybe it's just to put down Malin, I'm not sure. Alright, we need to put it into the scanner.
DNA sequence initiated. Complete.
Scanning. Can you get out of there?
I don't think so. Open that door.
Dispose of biological material for processing at recycling station 0314.
314. Dispose of me, damn you. Oh, I'm going through the recycling drain? Oh, because it's dispose of stuff. I guess that's where I am, 314. An organic soup is congealed around the edge of the recycling drain. I'm double clicking, he's not moving fast, guys.
Sleep now, my angel.
So horrible. Whoa! Okay, I'm hanging. How long can I hang here? Drainage pipes. The occasional guttural gurgle echoes deep down the drainage pipe. A foul solution spews from the open pipe. A faint smell of acrid smoke spews from the drainage vent. Signage B14. This facility is zoned as B14, which means there could be at least another 13 rooms just like this one. Okay, so we were in 314, and this is B14. Dead body in hazmat suit. Oh, does that mean I'm gonna jump off of here and wade through this crap? The bright yellow hazmat suit pointlessly still protects the decomposing corpse from the toxic environment. There's a PDA, of course. Walkway. Pitting corrosion is visible in the aluminum walkway. You have an exclamation point. I remember seeing an exclamation point a long time ago. Metal grating. Tough metal bars form a secure barrier to what lies beyond. Remains and acid. What was once living tissue is now disposed of in the most efficient manner. Biological tissue is burnt beyond recognition. I guess this is better than the furnace, right? The dead and organic matter cooked together in a caustic soup. The floating white meat is plump and bloated, while also blistering in the acidic concoction.
Oh, God.
A controlled stream of corrosive liquid spills from the siphon.
What's the siphon?
Pumping equipment. The technical apparatus used to pump and regulate the flow of chemicals in this processing and recycling plant. There's a terminal. The locked exit to the organic recycling facility is just out of reach. Airlock. The exit to the organic recycling facility, same thing. Just out of reach. Pumpage equipment. Yeah, same as this pumpage equipment. Okay, I guess this means I'm dropping down to the walkway. Although it's corroded, so this might be some danger there, especially if we're going to be falling down with some force. Okay, maybe not.
John? Hun? Are you there?
Hun? It's new.
Yes.
I found her. Your wife is in the military then. I'm on my way there.
Is she alive? Is she alive? Is she still completely human? Damn. Alright, let's look at this PDA. Oh, we don't really have logs here, huh? Deleted and damaged. Dwayne H. Jones, Drainage Service Technician Level 3, Log 1-988, deleted and or damaged. Abandonment. No feeling like it. Betrayal. There's another one that cuts deep. To be betrayed and abandoned by your own family? Well, what can I say? It's been 10 years since Maggie put my name into the Progressive Assisted Selected Suicide Lottery. For 10,000 cash from the government, no questions asked. Pass? What? Progressive Assisted Selected Suicide Lottery. They said it was a fantastic deal. All that cash and only a super slim chance that my name would be selected. Oh, great. It's like a lottery, which you can lose your life. The state wins in the long run with one less welfare case, and my family gets a cash bonus. Did I have a say in this? No. So April 15th rolls along, tax time, and bam, just my luck. My name is picked along with a few thousand other unlucky bastards. I did the only thing I could. The only thing I've ever really done. I ran. I joined Kane Corporation and headed as far away from my blood-sucking wife as possible. Well, you can add someone into this lottery without their permission? So I thought this was his assisted suicide, to live here until he died. I've worked my way up the ranks here. Level 3 gets me limited seed access, which means I clean up some weird, disgusting shit. But at least nobody talks to me or asks questions, so that suits me just fine. Who cares? At least I'm alive and kicking, master of my own destiny. Keeping that in mind, I've been stuck in this room for a few days now with only the dead as company. Nobody is looking for me, but at least the bodies have stopped falling into the acid vats. That green goo is my way out to a better place. A sip of that shit and I'll be assisting my own goddamn suicide. To anybody reading this, please pass this message on to my wife. Bleep you, Maggie. So you can really just enter his name.
Why does she... Well, obviously, why does she enter her own name? Because then she could live, you know, and stuff. She put his name in. Maybe you have to be related? Still, that's wrong. I mean, you should only be able to put your own name in. Maybe she, you know, put his social security number in. You know, identity theft kind of thing going on, but I don't know. All right, let's look around before we put this stuff on. A caustic cesspit swirls around the tank, occasionally burping a sulfuric stench into the air. I suspect there's no other way out. Saving, because... Also, this is going to end up in him being killed, but just in case. He can't get up there. So, I'm assuming this will help us get through here. Well, we have... All we have is this data thing. That's not gonna help us. Oh, I didn't take it? Glove? What? There's a glove there. Oh, I just took the glove off? 5 Teflon fingers protrude from the impermeable glove. Put glove on. Use glove on metal grating. I thought I was going to put the hazmat suit on. Fill the glove with acid. Yes. For what?
Okay. I'm going to finish chewing. It's dark. No lights.
Keep your head down. And stay away from the walls. And listen. You'll hear him before you see him.
Yes, okay. Okay.
Okay, so you've got a hazmat glove filled with acid. Well, I guess we need to use this to burn through the grate. Guessing we want the one with the lights? Can we use either one? Or both of them? Melted hazmat glove. Well, okay, so now we can only go through this one. Okay, we go up.
Too close. That was too goddamn close.
So one of those things?
Calm yourself. Panic and you won't make it. Focus. Breathe.
Now she's telling you. He's telling her to calm herself.
Shit, Tia. Come in.
That was loud.
I can hear you. I made it. I'm in a storage locker. I don't think they saw me. I'll contact you when I'm clear.
I'll be waiting.
Warning. Oxygen processor has experienced a critical failure.
Report to the visitor center
for immediate evacuation.
Mm-hmm. Corpses. Thomas Rohorska, cleaner. Security level 0. Nuno Andrade, waiter. Level 0. Human remains. The foul-smelling mountain of flesh crawls with several post-mortem insects. It's a veritable feast for them, huh? A.J. Schrader, provisional crewman. Security level 0. We got here webs? Spiders? Nicholas Vandermal Couchy. Level 0. A macabre mess of body parts. Lovely. Erland Howell, civilian. A series of interlocking teeth are wrapped around the mechanical wheels. So the cogs here. Prosthetic arm, which you can take. Radical advancements in artificial technologies have resulted in bionic arms and hands that are indistinguishable from real limbs. This prosthetic arm is made from a synthetic steel and carbon fiber composite. A.J. Schrader, provisional crewman. I think I looked at that one. A grisly pile of meat. Grisly pile of meat. Oh, the meat. Thomas White, morale officer. Alexander Bokash, civilian. Power distribution box. Oh, this walkway runs above. I thought this was like a separate area down below. This electrical node facilitates power distribution along this region of the Groomlake. And same there. This walkway. There's a terminal up there, but I can't even look at this stuff. We might end up going up there, though. Yummy! So you want that arm. And I'm gonna go get it. Something was just moving back there. Prosthetic limb. Wrapped in rubber.
I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
I'm looking over here for what's going on. Alright, so I want to get the power going to get this door open. Which you can do with this insulated, rubber arm.
I'm in the limb regeneration lab. There are arms, legs...
One step at a time. How close are you to Ellen?
She's in a storage bay. 2 floors up. I'm close.
So where exactly is she? She's heading from somewhere else. I don't have this anymore. I need to put something in the cogs. Oh, my own data thing? That's the only thing I have left.
That's just crazy. Although...
Alright, there's something I need to jam in there, obviously. There's plenty of remains around that I can just shove in there. But there's one certain thing we have to find. That thing was crawling around over here. Pixel hunting? Oh! What was that fell? crap out of me. The child-sized carcass appears soft and deflated. Brittle bones protrude, piercing the translucent skin at odd angles. What do we have? I want to look at that. Give me that. Hybrid intestines. Throw them in the cogs.
This is equipped with the emergency evacuation announcement system. Test 1, 2, 3.
A series of interlocking teeth are wrapped around the mechanical wheels. Okay. I feel a little nervous. That's fine, you can close me out of there.
Almost at the hangar.
The hangar.
John, I need to explain the situation.
Oh, do you?
Well, well, Sinsley. And it looks like you brought our friend along.
Is he gassing her? He might be gassing her at this point. The high-voltage wireless power pad provides a portable energy source for engineers and mechanics. An industrial refrigerator for storing objects requiring a low temperature. The coolant pipes for the refrigerators are active and in good condition. We need to get through there. The terminal is dusty but murmurs with power. Computer terminal for use by the supervising engineer for the collection and indexing of cargo. Corpse. PDA. Power pad's active. Okay, he stands on the power pad when I have him look at the refrigerator. Whose corpse is this? I guess the owner of that PDA. So let's see who this is. Jared Winslow. February 6th. I try real hard not to think any less of Scotty. But I swear the boy ain't got a caring bone in his body. Plus I bet he don't know what any of these big words he uses mean. He's always hinted that when we're back home we can be partners in business. I got myself a job on a damn spaceship. Does he reckon I need any help getting a job? March 15th, back before the rapid transport system was running through the Groomlake, folks used to get around in these really slow transport pods. I found one, tucked behind a pile of storage crates. I've been working on it for maybe a month now. I reckon I can get it working. April 1st, Scotty played an April Fool's joke on me. Dumped some water on me while I was working on the pod. I accidentally cut him real bad with a wrench. How do you cut someone with a wrench? I guess with the wrenching part? The side of the... I don't know. Anyways, I'm going to play a little joke on him and set his favorite book on fire. But not today. Sometime when he won't expect it. Is that a joke to set someone's book on fire? June 5th. Pod's coming along great. A couple more months and maybe I can test it out. My kid brother, Judd, would be so proud. He used to help me work on cars all the time. One time, we were fixing the brakes on this old clunker when one of the jacks broke. I know he's in a better place now, but I still feel... bad. Oh, really? The car fell on him? I pray about it every day, and I know that God knows that I didn't mean to do it. I promise to him that I'm trying not to be so angry anymore. He did it? August 22nd. All finished. Had to get some parts printed with the nanite machine, but I'm sure Stefan didn't mind much. Can't wait to try it out. Now I'm going back instead of hitting next because... well, there's a lot of entries. They are shorter, though. But sometimes the subject line or whatever this is after the date is not included or it appears later in the actual entry. That's why I'm clicking back and going manually into each one. August 23rd. Scotty says the pod won't work and that I'll get into trouble for it. What the hell does he think he is? Who the hell does he think he is? I made sure it would work. I ain't stupid. It's getting real hard to breathe and just pray about stuff. People like Scotty, God lets them live for one reason or other. He's gonna end up killing Scotty, isn't he? October 24th. Albert noticed some strange mushroom stuff growing all over engineering today. All over engineering today. Guess we're gonna have to get cleaning. Oh, wait. October 30th. Good news and bad news. We had to scrub like mama on laundry day, so the gunk is just about gone. Bad news is, it's all over the damn place. Scotty has been really nice since I burned that book of his. Really. So he really did it. Really? November 20th. Scotty's nicer every day. The Bible said he'd change if I was nice to him, and look what happened. A little bit of bread goes a long way in the house of God. Yeah, but wasn't this around the time people started getting violent? December 19th. Damn, this ain't good. The ship's on level 7 lockdown. Looks like we're gonna get real familiar with one another down here. December 23rd. Folks must have got mighty hungry. Screams are echoing everywhere. Scotty and me are gonna lock down engineering, shut down the baskets, and close the umbilical bridge. Keep them away from the twins. The twins. Folks must have got mighty hungry. Yeah, it's not really folks. So that's where we are, engineering. So shut down the baskets. So I might have to do this. Put the baskets back online and open up the umbilical bridge. And then some kind of twins. I don't know what those are. Equipment? Or actual twins? December 25th. It's Judd all over. I swear I didn't mean to. I couldn't get Scotty to shut it and stop making a ruckus. I just wanted to shut him up. I swear I didn't push too hard, but for God's sake, he was being so damn loud. It gets to where a guy can't take no more. He thought he was better than me all along. Well, he's dead now. He's staring at me. Gotta tuck him away somewhere. What does it mean it's Judd all over? Is that a Bible reference? Or maybe Judd's his brother? My kid brother Judd. Uh-huh. So it's like Judd all over again. So he, I guess, you know, in the heat of the moment, killed Judd. Like he killed Scott, so manslaughter, you know. And or murder. Well, Scotty's not too nice anymore, he's just dead. Last entry, December 27th. I hear him. He's been laughing, crying, cracking jokes. He won't stop. Can't get him to stop. Folks say I can just fix about anything with a screwdriver. Already fixed Scotty. Already fixed Judd. God wants us to fix folks up when they're broken. Can I fix me? Is he talking about himself? That he's been laughing, crying, and cracking jokes and won't stop? So he... Is that how he got rid of... Judd? Use the screwdriver to break the jack. And how did he kill? I didn't push too hard. Well, so much for Jared Winslow. Alright, well, next episode, guys, we're going to try to get through this, use this terminal, I guess, get through this door. So, thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and always, seek adventure.